Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Marvel Contest of Champions. So, yesterday, we had no updates whatsoever. We hadn't had updates in about 4 days, which was typical of the moderators on the forums for the thread that we have in question here. As you can see, we have tons of pages worth of stuff that needs to be sifted through to actually kind of see what is going on. But today, time's not exactly correct on this. As far as the actual time that she did post this, but Adora posted and said, "Hey everyone, I'm happy to confirm that this will be resolved in our next update. Thank you for your patience." Now, this is much better than a lot of the other things that we've seen so far in this thread about, you know, the unable to evade double dashback issue. At least now, we have a bit of a timeline to go off of, which is better than the previous statement that was made of, well, you know, we know it's an issue, we know it's causing people problems, we know we're benefiting from it and making money off of it, and we may get to it in a month, we may get to it in 2 months, or however long it takes between patches. Because originally it was, we may get it, you know, in this patch, we may get it in the next patch. We don't really know. We want to test it thoroughly so that it doesn't break other things in the game. And I think that's where a lot of the frustration comes from for people in this whole aspect of the issues. Because it seems like it's just been one thing after another. Since 12.0, that's just caused issue after issue after issue. And I don't think that some people can really fully grasp the concept of the idea that, you know, Kabam makes no money off of people who don't spend on this game. There are two separate kinds of entities inside of the mobile market. Games that are free to play, that have ads in them. If you play a game, an ad pops up. That company makes revenue off that ad. Same way with YouTube. If you see an ad on my videos, that's how I make money off of it. And the same concept goes for mobile games. Games like Contest to Champions are freemium games. You pay for either content or you pay for stuff inside of the game for the company to actually make money off of it. So if people aren't dropping money on the game, Kabam's not making money on it. That's just the way that the mobile market works. If there's no ads, that's the only way that they're going to make money off of. They don't make money off downloads. They don't make money off of daily active users. They make money off of purchases. And they make good money doing that too. Very, very good money off the purchases. Enough money so much that, you know, if an issue arises that detriments us, it should be like taken a lot more serious. And I've said this before too, we chalk things up to the Labyrinth of Legends. It was programmed the way they wanted it. It didn't work the way they had expected it to. People got through it very easily. They took it down. They fixed it. I mean, that was one of the big key things with this whole thing was, we have to get it approved before we could fix it. We have to test it thoroughly before we fix it. There was no getting it approved and taking weeks to do that with that issue. Or the Batista's challenge issue. Those are all, it doesn't matter. Does not matter in the least little bit if those issues were glitches that they needed to fix. You know what I mean? Because this is a glitch as well. A glitch that does not benefit us in the least. It hurts us. It's detrimental to us as players. Probably not so much everyone. There are people out there who don't seem to have an issue whatsoever with what's going on here. And that's fine. That's perfectly fine. If you don't feel that there's an issue whatsoever, you're entitled to that opinion. But for those of us that are actually suffering through this and having problems with it, it needs to be fixed and addressed. Just because there's a few people who think that, well, we can just play through this and we'll be okay. and we'll just, you know, accept the fact that this is the way the game is going to be, doesn't mean that everyone has to be that way. Some of us actually want to hold them up to the fact that we need the game fixed when there's something broke. You don't just sit back and, well, we'll just learn to adjust. That's not the way it's supposed to work with these kind of things. Not with these kind of companies. MMOs are, and this is an MMO, this is a massively multiplayer online game. Same as any other ones. Any other MMO that I've ever been a part of, there are constant downtimes for maintenance, just to make sure that everything's running. Anytime there's an issue like this that has to be addressed, it's usually solved as soon as possible. And I know that people got upset over the fact that I was calling for Alliance Quest and Alliance Wars to go down. This kind of stuff happens with MMOs all the time. If this is your first go around, I'm sorry if that upsets you, but that's just the way things work. Apparently there were issues with Star Wars The Old Republic, another game that I play, the other day, where they had went down for downtime, did server maintenance, and when they brought it back up, there was a glitch that on a certain server, people were losing things out of their inventory. They were just disappearing. And instead of just sweeping it under the rug for weeks and weeks and weeks and testing it to see what the issue was, because they couldn't replicate it, Swartor knew that there was an issue, and they dropped that server, or any server that that issue was happening on. They kept it down a lot longer than expected. Sure, there were people upset over the fact that their servers were down longer than anticipated, but they fixed the issue. They fixed the issue before they brought it back online. That's the way that MMOs are supposed to work. More people are going to be happy over the fact that time was taken to actually solve and correct the issue over top of not doing anything at all. And that's basically what happened with this, was it just kept getting swept under the rug. Swept under the rug. It took almost the full duration of the first Alliance Quest week for them to even acknowledge the fact that, hey, there might be an issue here. Something that every single one of us knew that had the issue or were seeing the issue on day one. We knew there was a problem. That puts more in question, you know, what is your, like, development team doing? That they don't even know the game well enough to be able to pick out these issues for days. When it's something that we can do in a matter of seconds. I mean, it's like, I know people are going to say this too, the fact that, well, we play it all the time. It's their game. They should know it better than anyone else, not us. Whenever you program and you code and put your blood, sweat, and tears into something, you should know that better than anyone else. It shouldn't always just fall on us to find things. And when we do, it shouldn't take 4 to 5 days for you to be able to replicate that issue either. I know they've got a lot of other stuff going on in-game. Lots of other issues. I mean, we can go to and look at just a couple of the numerous issues that we have in known issues. I mean, it's all here. Known issues. AI attacking while evading. Android 5 13.0 login problems. Possible auto bug fight. Auto fight bugs. 13.0 login issues. Known issue. Missing mastery rewards in event quest. There is a lot of stuff that goes on here. I mean, this is just like scratching the tip of the iceberg. There is definitely more along the lines down through here that haven't even been, you know, stickied yet as issues or problems that are going to be solved or fixed. And I understand that. I think I'm a very patient person. I really do. I even in this last video, it wasn't a call to arms to let's just boycott right now. I said let's give them until the start of the next Alliance Quest, and if they start it with this problem, don't have any kind of solution or anything for us in that matter, then we need to. And it's like, I know some people just come in and see that one video, and it's like, oh, well, you just need to be patient. You need to be patient. This has been building up. There have been I've done a lot so far with this issue. Three videos I've made. The first one, just kind of getting it out there that this is an issue, you know, be aware of it, take heed. The second one was a plea to them to fix it. And, I mean, I took, you know, the same amount of time they normally do, like 3 or 4 days in between, to make the videos. And I tweeted it to Kabam at that point. I actually tweeted the plea video to them, and you would think that something like that would actually reach them, considering the fact that they do follow me back as well. So it's there. They don't have enough people that they follow that their news feed would be completely corrupted to the point where they wouldn't be able to see the actual video that goes out, especially considering the fact that I don't normally tweet them. Do not normally tweet at them to begin with. And then the third video, which was still not even, you know, saying let's boycott. It was let's give them a little bit more time before we do. And we still don't have a resolution, though. It could be. There's no time frame on it. That's the thing that scares me the most with this. 2 weeks? Okay. I mean, I don't like the idea of 2 weeks, but I can live with it and try to push through for 2 weeks until the next patch comes out. But is the patch going to be in 2 weeks? Or is the patch going to be in 3 weeks, 4 weeks, you know, a month and a half, 2 months? How long? There's no timetable set in place here. I love the idea of Kabam putting out the fact that they're going to be more transparent with things. But these kind of issues just really scream non-transparency. We don't need every single little update. Like, if you go down to your development team and they give you no information whatsoever, you know, the 1 to 4 days, whatever, response times are okay. That's fine if they're not giving you anything. But it's really hard to believe that the development team would go 4 days without having any kind of solution whatsoever. Anything that is being developed for future content at the point of having this many bugs in a game should really be put on the back burner, and the bugs should be the main thing that's being addressed. Work on the other stuff once the things are fixed. I know that's the way most any other MMO works. But the big key thing here, and the one that I like the most, as you can see, I posted after she did, when is the scheduled date for the next update? I try to be as cordial with these people as I possibly can. I do. We should all be. They should be as cordial back with us as they possibly can. There are some that are a little bit more off the cuff than others, in especially in this thread. But we should still be cordial back to them. They're just people like us. This is the one that I like, though. Not celebrating yet until it's released and tested, which would mean tested by us. Without knowing when the next update will be, we're still stuck with using items in Alliance Quest, ergo funding Kabam's incompetence in treating its player base. Recommendations on revives and potions while this nasty bug is active have triggered zero response. And that's true. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. And that's where we stand. The last little sentence there really sums it up. We can be happy about the fact that something is being addressed here. We can be unhappy about the fact that we don't have a timetable. But ultimately, is this going to be enough to push off an actual boycott? We don't know. Number one, I'm not the head of the boycott. I am by no means the head of the boycott. Whether I say boycott or don't boycott, if it comes, it's going to happen. So just be prepared at that point. But all right, guys, that's all there is for this update. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Hopefully you were a little bit more informed about things moving forward with this, and a little bit more of how things work as far as MMOs go with these kind of aspects in mind. But if you enjoyed the video, please remember to smash that like button. If you're new to the channel, please consider leaving a sub on it. And if you do, remember to hit that bell notification so you get notifications every single time I post a video or I go live. Or link down in the description below for Twitter, much more reliable source for notifications as far as I'm concerned. And as always, I'll catch you in the next episode. Later.